Welcome everyone, you're watching Republic TV. I'm Shivani Gupta, and the top story we're following at this hour is the outrage that is coming in now because a journalist, Rahul Bedi, in UK Daily Telegraph has referred to Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, an icon of modern independent India, as a radical Hindu nationalist. I go across to Kolkata. My colleague Amita is now joining us with a grand nephew of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. I want to go across to Amita to capture the first emotions that are coming in from the family of this great hero of this land, calling him a Hindu radical nationalist. Amita, over to you.
Yes, definitely it's a big insult to a freedom fighter like Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, and calling him a radical Hindu rebel, and he formed a rebel army. It is a big insult. Definitely I am here with Chandra Kumar Bose, and he's reading the article right now, and how he shared his thoughts that he's definitely very angry. This is insulting and this shouldn't have been done, and it looks like that it's been distorted history. So,
well, I am not surprised. The Telegraph, the British Daily, one Mr. Rahul Bedi has written this article. You see, Subhash Chandra Bose was the number one enemy of the British Empire. There were other leaders of that era who were British stooges. So a British daily would obviously praise the British stooges and criticize the actual real enemy of the empire. The Bose brothers, my grandfather Sarat Chandra Bose, his younger brother Subhash Chandra Bose, were the foremost opponents of the British Empire. Now, these are not my words. These are words of Lord Clement Attlee. Lord Clement Attlee was the British Prime Minister who signed the transfer of power documents. Now, these are documented in the British archives. Clement Attlee came to Calcutta in 1956, and he very clearly told the then acting governor of West Bengal, Justice Fanibhushan Chakravarti, that Britain had to relinquish India because of Subhash Chandra Bose and Azad Hind Fauj, and the subsequent INA trials, which were held at the Red Fort, completely shook the very foundations of the British Empire in India. You know, the loyalty and allegiance of the British armed forces were completely destroyed. That is the reason why Britain finally quit India. So what this British Daily Telegraph and Mr. Bedi, it is a deliberate attempt by the British stooges to distort the heroic battle of the Azad Hind Fauj, the contribution of the liberator of India, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. I think the government of India should take immediate strong steps against the Telegraph and Mr. Bedi. Penal action should be taken for distorting the history of India's freedom struggle.
Sir, also Mr. Bedi, who claims to be a journalist, don't you think that it is a very attempt of distorting the history or putting the contribution of Azad Hind Fauj and Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose's contribution in Indian freedom in a bad light?
You see, the NDA government, under the leadership of Narendra Modi ji, we are making efforts to correct the distortion in history. And here is a man, Mr. Bedi, who is obviously a stooge of the Congress Party and the British, who is making a deliberate attempt to distort the history, to further distort the history. I think punishment is the only step should be taken against such journalists. You see, the journalists have a responsibility towards society. If a journalist is trying to deliberately distort history, he should be punished. Strong action should be taken against him. Because 21st century
Mr.
India,
Bose,
we would correct the distorted history written by successive Congress governments.
Mr. Bose, sir, that's precisely the issue, it seems. Do you think there's a certain section that is very nervous with the fact that the current government is trying to give its due to leaders like Subhash Chandra Bose? And that is why there is a section, maybe perhaps within the media as well, that is hitting back so hard when somebody like Netaji gets his due finally?
Absolutely. You see, for the last 72 years, the heroic battle of the Azad Hind Forge, the contribution of people like Mangal Pandey, the Sepoy Uprising, then Shahid Bhagat Singh, Rajguru, where are the contributions of these heroes? When efforts are being made to write the correct history, obviously there is paranoia among the people who have very successfully distorted history over the last 72 years. But I think the nation would oppose such traitors who are still trying to distort history. And I warn Mr. Bedi that if you want to live in India, please don't distort the history of the Azad Hind Forge. Don't distort the history of the liberator of India, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. It is a warning to you. You can do your journalism, but this is not journalism that would be accepted by India and Bharat.
Mr. Bose, not only is the article in real bad taste, and of course, the historical facts themselves are highly contested. These three words, radical Hindu nationalist, I mean, don't you feel that it is highly communal as well?
You see, Subhash Chandra Bose was the only leader. Why did Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose stand out as a different kind of a leader? Because he refused to use religious symbols for political purposes. He was the only inclusive leader of that era. Let's face it, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was the only inclusive leader of that era. He refused to use religious symbols for political purposes. These are not my words. These are words of a British historian. So such a leader, there were no Hindus, there were no Muslims, there were no Sikhs, no Christians in the Azad Hind Forge. There were only Bharatiyas. Netaji established people as Bharatiyas in the Azad Hind government and Azad Hind Forge. And today, Narendra Modi ji has stated in Andaman speech that he would follow the ideology, the inclusive ideology of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose in 21st century India. So this gentleman, obviously, either he is deliberately doing it or he is completely ignorant about the ideology of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, which is an inclusive ideology, which is an ideology that we are all Bharatiyas. And today's context, we have to implement Subhash Chandra Bose's ideology of being a Bharatiya. Otherwise, India would again be partitioned. India would again disintegrate. So the only path to save India is to implement Subhash Chandra Bose's inclusive ideology.